Well now, unfamiliar faces. What brings you to Eastpool, travelers?
We're looking for an elderly bearer. You wouldn't happen to have seen him, would you?
Ah, you mean the old boy who always waits by the well?
Yes, that's him.
What business do you have with him, if you don't mind me asking? You're not from the capital too, are you?
We are, in a way.
Well then, it's a pleasure to meet a fellow Rosalithian. I was born and raised down Market Street. And never would have left if Archduke Elwyn had survived the fire. It wasn't the same when the Duchess took over, though. All the beatings, the evictions, the levies going up and up and up, even as the blight took half the harvest. Oh, listen to me, telling you what you already know. I'm sorry. And I'm afraid I can't help you with your bearer either, though I doubt he'll have gone far. He comes here every day, almost as if he's waiting for something.
We'll keep asking around then. Thank you.
Good day, m'lady. What can I do for you?
I'm looking for a bearer, an elderly fellow who used to serve the Rosfields. Have you seen him?
Ah, that old loon. No, no sign of him today. Funny, he's usually down by the well at this hour, cooking up his fantasy feasts.
I'm sorry?
Oh, he worked in the kitchens at Rosalith Castle back in the day. Still thinks he's there now. You'd often hear the poor fool chatting away to the Archduke. Living in a dream he is. But better there than here, I suppose. Can't imagine the Viceroy stopping to trade tales with a bearer. Can you?
No.
Anyway, you'll be round here somewhere. Doubt he has the path to stray too far.
Thank you. We'll keep looking.
Hey, hold on a mo. Young Patrick, the chocobo keeper, might know where he is. He's taken the old bird under his wing, so to speak. He'll be in the stables. You should go and have a word with him.
Patrick the chocobo keeper. Thank you. We will.
I'm sorry, Jill. For making you do all this in my stead.
It can't be helped if we're to keep up the pretense. Come on, let's head for the stables.
Where the bloody hell's he got to?
Excuse me, but is something the matter?
It's this bearer I've been minding. I take my eyes off him for 1 minute and he disappears. He's not in his usual spot by the well nor anywhere else in the village.
You must be Patrick.
I am, but...
And this bearer you're looking for, he's an elderly man who used to work in the Rosalith Castle kitchens, yes?
That's the fella. How do you know all this? I've never seen you in Eastpool before, but you seem to know the place better than I do myself. So that's how it is. Well then, if you're acting under orders of the mayor, you're on a bound to help me find him. He's been losing what little sense he had left of late, saying the sheriffs are coming to collect him and that he needs to go back to the castle. I was supposed to watch over him, keep him out of trouble. But if he's walked out on us, there's not a lot I can do.
Understood. You keep searching here. We'll look for him outside.
Thank you. I'm in your debt.
I hope he hasn't wandered into trouble.
Let's just concentrate on finding him. Still no sign. could have strayed even further. Someone over there.
It might be him. We should hurry. Company.
We can't lead them to the old man. They need to die.
Agreed.
Give them all you've got, boy.
Stay down. Are you all right, my friend? Come on. Let's go home.
Your Grace, you came for me. I waited for you so long, but you finally came.
I'm not who you think.
Clive.
Yes. Pray forgive my long delay.
It's nothing, Your Grace. I prayed to the Founder that you would come, and at long last, he answered. Will we be returning to the castle then? There is still a place for me in the kitchens?
No, my friend. We will not be returning to the castle, not yet. I'm on a very important expedition, one which may take some time. Could you wait for me in Eastpool until my journey is complete. I will come back for you then. I promise.
Of course, Your Grace. For you, I would gladly wait until my dying day.
Thank you, both of you. You've been most kind. The memory of serving the late Archduke was his one light in the darkness, and now that light burns a little more brightly. It's nothing but a fantasy, of course, but it's better than the truth of the matter. A damn sight better. The blight is on our doorstep. Our harvests are failing. The people are leaving in droves. If it weren't for Lady Hannah selling half her worldly goods to provide for the few of us who stayed behind, we would long since have starved. We want to keep the bearers safe here, we really do. But unless a miracle happens, we won't be able to spare a crust of bread to share between them soon enough.
Is it really that bad?
So bad, I even petitioned the Imperial Garrison to take them. But when they found out where they'd come from, they damn near spat in our faces. Ducal dogs, they called them. Enemies of the Empire.
I know a man named Cid, who would gladly give a home to any bearer in need of one. Leave this with me. As soon as I return from Phoenix Gate, I'll speak with him.
Thank you, my lord. Will you be passing through Eastpool on your way back? I should very much like to speak with you again, if you have the time, regarding the future of the village And what might be done for Lady Hannah. After all, she's done for us.
Yes, of course. I'll be back anon.
Fare you well, my lord, my lady. I wish you a safe journey.
The Deadlands are aptly named.
I didn't realize they were this close.
No wonder their crops are failing. The blight is leaching the ether from the soil. And when the last drop is drained, their fields will turn to this. No plants, no animals, no life.
And no monsters. I suppose that's one small mercy.
We won't be able to use any magic here.
Another thing to worry about. As if the absence of ether didn't cause enough problems.
Take away the lad's life force, and problems are all that's left.
I can hardly imagine what this place used to look like before the Blight took it.
I remember. It was beautiful.
Come on, Clive. It's time to discover the truth. Almost as if time had stood still.
I suppose no one had any cause to return here. No. It's just as I left it.
Could anyone?
What is it, Torgal? Clive.
That's him. He's the only one who can tell me what happened. I have to know. Where is he?
Nowhere to be seen.
Damn it! He's like a bloody eel.
What is this place, anyway? Some sort of shrine?
Oh, sorry. You've never been here before. This is the Hall of the Gate.
The Gate?
It's a relic of the Fallen. Only the Phoenix's dominant can open it.
Hence the castle's name. This was where Joshua was supposed to...
Yes. He would have stepped through this door the next morning and listened to the words of our ancestors.
Would you have gone with him?
No. The Apodotry is holy ground. None but the Dominant may enter. I and the other shields would have stood guard here and prayed for my brother's safe return. Where the hell did he go?
Perhaps he went inside.
He couldn't have. He'd need the power of the Phoenix. Thank you, Joshua.
Are you sure about this?
Nevermore. Another gate. Let's see if this one opens.
Hardly call it a ruin. It's perfect. Like it was built yesterday.
Have you ever seen anything like this?
There, boy! Too slow!
trouble.
This must be what the fallen ruins were like before they fell. Makes sense to you?
None. Let's find a hooded man and leave.
Not this time.
Joshua have had to run this gauntlet too?
No. At least not that I ever heard about. I imagine the Phoenix would receive a warmer welcome.
Here we go again. Where will we end up this time?
Surrounded by contraptions hell-bent on murdering us, I expect. Could the Hooded Man really have taken this path?
We won't know until we've followed it all the way to the end. Come on, let's keep looking.
Get him, boy!
like this.
Seems the feeling's mutual.
It's done.
What are these creatures? And why do they keep attacking us?
They're probably asking themselves the same thing. We're the ones trespassing here. They're just protecting their home. Jill, look.
Is that some kind of mural?
It's worth a closer look, whatever it is. then.
This place holds even more secrets than we thought.
Something.